Yes, there she is, finally out of the garage. Let's get that cold start. If that doesn't put a smile on your face, I don't know what will. And windows down from the tunnel. What's up, everybody? Welcome to Hammerdown Motorsports. My name is Steve Fast. You guys are new to the channel, and we are having a bit of a cloudy day here in Pennsylvania. We are at 62 degrees. No complaints here. It's like the middle of October, so yeah, pretty decent weather here for fall, and we're pretty much just going to be going for a little cruise today and talking to you about something that happened to the truck, because last night was a little bit of a tough one for me. I was pretty concerned about what happened, and I'm very, very happy that it's been solved. So here it is, a little bit of a backstory on how this all came to be. We had the truck in my shop for about a week, had the wheels off, I had the fender liners out, I was putting the other rock lights in. I know how much you guys love those, but I honestly do think they're awesome. But either way, I was installing those, and I had everything taken apart, so I had to run a bunch of wiring. Obviously, we had to run from the right rear all the way to the front where I had the module, because we actually had to put in some extensions on those just because the wires were too short. So I ordered some online, not a big deal. They're like $10 for two of them. So I ended up putting in six in total to get the rock lighting working so I could reach all the corners. And while I was doing all that wiring, I figured I might as well do the bed lights as well. So that was kind of the thing. That was the video I was making. I filmed it all, and I've kind of run out of time today to be able to actually do the edit on it. So that will be coming up soon. But yes, we do have the bed lighting in the truck. I didn't terminate it yet because I'm going to get the dealership to program it. They actually have to go in the computer and tell the truck that it has LED bed lighting, and they have to pin in the two little connectors that go into the BCM. So I'll leave that up to them since they have to program it anyway, and we'll go from there. But what happened was I ended up getting the wiring all done. I had everything just kind of loosely under the dash here so the dealership could take care of it once I get back from my trip. Heading out to CamaroCon. It's Lethal Camaro's event. We are going to be checking out some awesome Camaro content. So for all you Camaro people out there, definitely check out the upcoming uploads, because we're going to be taking you guys on that adventure. We're going to be road tripping from California all the way to Vegas and then all the way back. So should be a very good time. But back to our story. So I have the wiring all where I wanted it. I was gonna pin it in myself, but I was kind of thinking, as I was reading the instructions at the very end, I was like, well, I think I'll just leave that, because honestly, the dealership has to program it anyway. They might as well just pin it in at the same time, and I didn't want to have any issues. But at the very beginning, because I was kind of following along with the instructions, I disconnected the battery, and yeah, the battery was the issue. It was disconnecting the battery caused me a very, very scary situation when I reconnected it. So it's kind of late already. I had everything put back together on the truck. These fender liners, by the way, are kind of a pain, and yeah, I fought with them a little bit, and either way, they're in and just took a little bit of time. But just so you know, if you want to take them out, they're a little bit tedious to get back together if you don't get everything just aligned perfectly. But I reconnected the battery. I reconnected the battery sensor, just like the instructions said. I turn on the truck, fires up, no problems, no lights, no problems, anything like that. And I go to the center screen, and I see that satellite radio is not even there. There's no option for it. You can go into source, and it goes HD radio. That was it. It was just giving me regular radio. I was like, this is odd. And so I went to go take the truck out for a test drive just to make sure there wasn't anything else going on. And as I'm driving, I'm like, okay, I don't really feel the AC working, but I do feel heat. And I tried to do the manual controls on my screen, and it wouldn't work. The manual buttons did nothing. So I went into climate, and then I would change it with the actual screen, and it would move. So I didn't know why the buttons weren't working. But the AC still wasn't working, so it was just basically giving me full heat. I could change the blend doors and all that kind of thing, but just, yeah, there was no AC whatsoever. Also, the first problem that I noticed was when I put it in reverse. I had no reverse camera at all. There was no black screen. There was nothing. You put it in reverse, it's the same screen as the radio was, and backing up as if you had no camera at all. And also, one more thing happened. My heated seats, even though we don't have AC seats, we still have heated seats in this truck, but they were gone. No heated seats, no heated steering wheel, no heated passenger seat, nothing like that. You have the dimming mirror option, that was it. So basically, kind of what I figure it did is the BCM, after the battery was disconnected, kind of defaulted to like base settings. Like, it didn't have AC, it didn't have heated seats, it didn't have a backup camera, all those things that it just didn't think it had them. And it was very, very strange. Now, I did have one issue prior to this, but prior to ever disconnecting the battery, and the satellite radio disappeared on me once. Like, the option was still there, but it wasn't lit up, like you couldn't select it. So I tried to select it, yeah, nothing happened, and I waited probably about half a day or so, like a couple of startups later, it worked again, and everything's been fine ever since. So yeah, that kind of had me a little bit concerned. But this was the biggest one, where I lost all those options all at one time just from disconnecting the battery and reconnecting it exactly how the instructions show you. So yeah, that is something that if you have this issue, can be remedied. And the remedy to it is something that you might not think. I thought for sure I was going to be taking this thing to the dealership and I was going to have them reflash the BCM and make sure that, you know, everything that it was supposed to have would be back and they would have it fixed. But then there's also the blame game the dealership plays. That are like, oh, well, you're installing something on your vehicle and you have a pedal max, and oh, you put rock lights on it. That must be the problem, because that's the problems that I've had with dealerships over time. Is they love to blame everything that's wrong with your vehicle on something that you did. So obviously none of that stuff has anything to do with it, because rock lights are a completely independent system. The only connection they have is at the battery. They have their own switch that has their own relay and all that kind of stuff. It's fused, it's all done properly. And the pedal max, it just allows the throttle plate to open up quicker. It doesn't affect anything with any modules or anything like that. So, I mean, none of those things would have been a problem. And they didn't actually give me any trouble, because I didn't actually have to take it to the dealership, because the problem fixed itself. I left it overnight. I left the battery plugged in overnight. I got back in the truck pretty upset already that my brand new truck with 900 miles, I just made my first payment on it, and it was all messed up last night. I started up this morning, RAM came up and said Sirius satellite radio, and that was a good sign, because I don't think it said that before, because I think it didn't think it had a satellite radio for some reason. And yeah, everything was back. Everything works perfectly again, and all I did was let it sit a little longer. So if you have disconnected your battery and you have issues, I know this is not probably what you want to hear, but they can just fix themselves. It'll just go back to normal after it sits for a while. It's a little strange. And yeah, I never want to say Scotty Kilmer's ever right about anything, because I mean, some of his videos are a little bit opinionated, I think, in my personal opinion, which I'm entitled to as well, but we'll get into that in another video. But all in all, in the end of the day, the Ram Rebel is back. It is working 100% like it would from the factory. I did have those issues though, and I wanted to share that. So if you're freaking out because you disconnected your battery for something that you did, and now you've lost everything that I lost on this truck, don't worry. It more than likely will come back on its own. So I know people are gonna say, oh, it's FCA, it's Fiat, it's junk, you know, like they don't have the proper technology to make things of high quality and whatever, which I don't find is true at all. There is just gonna be little glitches and things like that that they have to go through and kind of figure out with the software. And if you have a computer, you obviously know how many people have a computer that lasted them forever with no issues. Everybody's always having to update them. They're always trying to figure it out and try to make it better. That's just how technology is. And the more advanced the technology gets, the more complicated it gets, and the more they have to kind of work through different issues as they arise. And that's kind of probably what we're dealing with here. But with that being said, I absolutely am enjoying every minute of this Rebel. I was a little scared, like I said, about all those issues, but that's why I wanted to share it with you guys so you don't freak out like I did, because I was scouring the internet trying to figure out what could possibly have gone wrong and, you know, if there's anything I could do to fix it. But at the end of the day, they just need a little bit of time. So there you go. That's what you need to do if you do have this issue. Just relax. It's not your truck going to be completely messed up forever or have to go to the dealer or anything like that. So we got it all figured out. Very happy about that. This truck's been absolutely awesome. I mean, I love just cruising around in this thing, and it rides so well. Everything about it that I've done to it so far has been pretty good. I really wish I could have done the headlight mod, but we've been through that. There was kind of just an issue that we ran into, and it's just kind of been plagued a little bit in the last couple of mods, us having issues, but I think that hopefully we're out of that area now and we can move on to the next thing. And hopefully the next thing we put on this truck is going to be problem free, and I'm really excited to do that. So being that I'm going to California for the next couple of days, we're going to switch up the content a little bit here on the channel, and I hope you guys enjoy those videos. I really don't know what to expect. We're just going to be going out to the event and just kind of just rolling the camera and seeing what happens. There's some awesome cars that we're going to be seeing out there, and it's going to be an absolutely awesome time, so I can't wait to share that with you guys, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, and as always, keep that hammer down.